Malyssa, Lois, and Keira, the whole congregation has been holding you in our prayers. We're so sorry to have heard of Melissa Ann's death. And just know, if it wasn't COVID times, you guys would be getting hugged on today a lot.
Oh, yeah,
and even beyond these COVID times, we are all lifting you up in prayer. So continued prayers for the Yerrick family. Continued prayers also, please, for Kay Smith and for Judy Fitz's daughter and son-in-law, all who have been diagnosed positive with COVID.
Oh my.
And then Bonnie Hampton, you haven't seen here in worship for a while. She has a pinched nerve in her back and is in a lot of pain. She has begun some treatment for that, and so we can hope that that treatment will make a positive difference for her. I think those are all the announcements I have to share this morning. We're ready for the Christ King. candle to be lit. Attention, you have noticed that the kings, the wise men, are slowly making their way to the stable. They won't arrive until Epiphany, so it's slow going. And each week we are adding figures to our creche, filling out the story there as well. Remember you are baptized and be thankful. We're ready for lighting the Advent wreath. We read light the Advent candle of hope, reminding us that our hope is in God's promise that Christ can fill our lives and the world with new life. We read light the candle of love, trusting that God's love is unfailing, that God's love is not scarce.
This morning we light the pink candle, representing joy. God sent angel messengers to earth to proclaim the good news, that God was coming among us to live as one with us. In spite of missing so many things we thought were essential to a Merry Christmas, like shopping in malls filled with people going to parties with friends and gathering family together to open gifts and share meals, God can still invite joy in our lives under the loss and sorrows that we are feeling this year. Let us pray. Gracious God, help us hear the angelic message. Do not be afraid. Remind us and show us all the things we can celebrate this Christmas. Fill our hearts with joy for the many gifts that are ours. Amen.
Peace be with you. Almost forgot. Peace be with you. And then to each other, and also with you. Like Bill's. You guys are so creative. I watch for what you're doing. Please join me as we call ourselves to worship. The Lord has done great things for us.
Rejoice.
The Lord has done great things for us.
Rejoice.
Loving God, we rejoice in this season as we remember your promise. Your promise to be Emmanuel, God with us. Come among us, we pray, as we open your word, as we proclaim your word, and as we seek to live your word. Amen. There are two short verses this morning that I want to share with you. One from Psalm 97, the other from John's Gospel, the first verse. Both remind us on this Gadot Sunday, this Joy Sunday of Advent, that we have much to give celebration to. From Psalm 97, the Lord is King. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many coastlands be glad. Rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous, and give thanks to God's holy name. And then from the first chapter of the Gospel of John. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. This is the word of the Lord, the word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We keep moving steadily on through this pandemic the world finds itself in, and our times are marked with anxiety under the constraints that COVID has put on us. We keep moving through winter as the days grow darker toward the winter solstice, and the skies are often too gray. But we also keep moving through Advent. And on this third Sunday, this Gadot Sunday, we focus on joy. Lauren Alleman, known as Lo the Poet, shares the gospel of Jesus through poetry. He says that in the beginning was a song, and the song was God's joy. And God was joy. That's what we want to focus on this morning. The joy that is ours because Jesus has come. Because we know him and trust him and follow him. This morning, I invite you to let your inner child come out and play a bit. To be joyful, even in church. I would say the ceiling wouldn't fall on us, but you guys experience the ceiling falling. We are going to hear and see and sing the good news of Jesus' birth in three different ways this morning. Fear not, there is joy in good news. Our first this morning is a video clip that is on YouTube called Christmas According to Kids. This was recorded by Southland Christian Church.
Walk to the side.
sometimes only kids know how to tell the story for us. In between these three tellings, we're going to sing one verse of There's a Song in the Air. Times in the biblical story, angels come bearing news, saying, "Do not be afraid." God sent an angel messenger to Mary, and God spoke to Joseph through a dream. A sky full of angels appeared to the shepherds, and God warned the wise men about Herod in a dream. I wonder what message God might be trying to tell us this Advent season. I wonder what an angel might tell us not to be afraid of. Thank you. The wise men are next. The Magi followed a star that led them to the stable. Listen to this portrayal of the wise men. "We are the wise men, but we are not smart in the usual ways. We cannot make a chair. Our soups are regrettable. We forget important facts. How long again can camels go without having water? What galvanizes us are big pictures. How all things are held together, even though they look like they are apart. For us, nothing is as it seems. A star moves across the sky, and we are in the saddle, convinced that the birth of the predicted has occurred." See, it seems to me that the wise men saw deeper meanings to what was happening around them. And so, I wonder what deeper meanings you might be seeing in the world around us this Advent season. Thank you. Next, we have Mary. Wait, you're baby Jesus, remember? remember? Mary is in your picture, you're right, but you're not Mary. You're baby Jesus. Because Keira is Mary. The angel told a young Jewish girl, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God." I am always amazed that Mary's response to God was yes. "Here I am. Let it be with me according to your word," Mary said. I think God saw more in Mary than she saw in herself. When Mary said yes to God, her whole world changed. And I wonder what she treasured most from her years of mothering Jesus. I wonder what God might be asking us, and if we are willing to say yes to God like Mary did. Thank you, Keira. Joseph is next. God told Joseph, "Take Mary for your wife." Mary would have a son, and Joseph was told to name him Jesus. Joseph always seems to be at the back of the manger. Have you noticed that? He never seems to have much to say. But the thing I notice most about Joseph is that he is obedient. He is faithful. He uses his strength to protect and provide for Mary and her baby. And so I wonder how we, like Joseph, might serve God simply by being who we are and offering our gifts as they are needed. I wonder what quiet ways we might make a difference in someone's life. Thank you, Jim. Next is the shepherd. The angels filled the night sky singing the good news of Jesus' birth. The angels told the shepherds that Jesus had titles: Savior, Messiah, Lord. But I don't think the shepherds headed to the stable because of Jesus' titles. I think they left their hills and found the manger because they couldn't resist the joy that the angels sang about. I think about how the angels end up being like sheep themselves, cared for by the infant who becomes the good shepherd. I wonder why God chose the poor, undervalued, and seemingly unimportant shepherds to be the first to hear of Jesus' birth. Thanks, God. Now Jesus comes forward. The white candle that we light on our Advent wreath is the Christ candle, which we will light on Christmas Eve. Jesus was born, just as the angel said. Most of us place baby Jesus in the front of our creches, in the center of our creches usually. And that makes sense, because God wants us to put Him in the center of our lives. Jesus Christ, Emmanuel, God with us, has come and will come again. That is all the reason we need to celebrate, even during a pandemic. Because of all that the pandemic has taken from us this year, I wonder if we might focus more on the true meaning of Christmas this year. Since everything is so out of whack this year, I wonder how you might find creative ways to celebrate the Christ child's birth this year. Fear not. There is joy in good news. And the good news is ours to celebrate and to share. Let us pray. Lord, your song is joy. The joy of good news. Joy that sings light into darkness. Joy that echoes with the song of angels. Joy that births hope in the midst of despair. Open our lips to sing your praise and receive your melody of joy into our lives. Amen. Thank you, God. We're going to sing another hymn. Another verse of the hymn. Shepherd. if you hear the word good news, you say yes.
Yes.
Good news.
Yes.
Yes.
And if you hear the phrase great joy, you say amen. Great joy.
Amen.
Good news.
Yes. Yes.
All right. Dad is going to try and help me through. Okay, you guys, pay attention. Here we go. Long ago, in a country far away from this one, there were shepherds.
Oh, sheep.
Watching over their sheep. Being good shepherds.
Oh, sheep.
They protected their sheep. Made sure they had food to eat and water to drink and gathered them together at night for protection. The shepherds.
Yo, sheep.
Were listening to the soft sounds of the sheep as they quieted down for the night to go to sleep. The dark sky was full of shimmering stars that night, and then all sounds stopped, and an angel appeared to them. They were bathed in light almost as if they glowed from within. The shepherds were frightened, and so were the sheep. The angel spoke to them, "Don't be afraid. I have some good news."
Yes.
My good news will bring great joy.
Amen.
The good news is this. This very day in David's town, a baby. A baby was born. And this baby is your Savior, Christ the Lord. The shepherds were amazed, and so were the sheep. What they thought was going to be like every other evening had turned into a holy night. The angel,
behold.
Come on, angel. The angel,
behold.
Well, that was better. Told them to go to Bethlehem where they would find the baby. Then the sky was filled with angels.
Behold.
Singing praises to God, proclaiming the good news.
Yes.
With great joy.
Amen.
The shepherds looked at each other and at the sheep. We should go to Bethlehem and see the baby. They said. And so they hurried off and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. When the shepherds saw him, whoops, I didn't get a time. I'm losing control. Okay. When the shepherds saw him, they told Mary and Joseph what the angel had told them about the baby. And that they had come to see the good news for themselves so that they could share the great joy.
Amen.
Everyone who heard what the shepherds had to say were amazed. Mary listened to all that was said and treasured it in her heart. The shepherds went back into the hills to their sheep, singing praises to God for all that they had seen and heard. It had been just as the angel had told them. They had knelt before the baby, received the good news, and felt great joy.
Amen.
And when they were finally settled down, they turned to each other and proclaimed, "What a night." The end.
Amen.
We are going to sing this next verse. There's a song in here.
Thank you.
Sunday, as Presbyterians customarily do, bring a love offering, the Christmas joy offering, which goes to retired pastors and students in the seminary. So, if you have it in your heart and in your wallet, we ask you to contribute.
Thank you, Bob. Mission Committee has put envelopes in the pews, and we will be accepting those this Sunday and next for the joy offering. Please join me in prayer. Eternal God, gracious Father, you comfort those who mourn, heal the afflicted, deliver the captives, and bring hope to those who despair. We give you thanks for the gift of your Son, Jesus, who brings us forgiveness and salvation, mercy and grace. We give you thanks for your Holy Spirit, who guides and inspires and strengthens us. As we have received the light of your love, let us live as people filled with that light, who share your love with others. We pray that we, too, might be a voice proclaiming the good news of your promise. We pray for the anointing of your Spirit upon us, so that we might become bearers of good news to the world. We pray for this church, Lord, your church. We pray that we might be a place of welcome for all who come to worship and belong. We pray that we might respond to the voices of children and youth, the aging, the middle-aged, and all that come seeking relationship with you. We pray for our world. We need signs of your peace, Lord. As we see and hear about the wilderness places in our world, places filled with anger and violence, poverty and injustice, hunger and need, we pray that you might use us as joyful witnesses of a better way. In the name of the one who time after time rescues and restores us, who can turn tears to joy and bring light into the darkness, we pray with one voice, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I am going to call a congregational meeting to order. not been joining us in person. So thank you, Sandy. Thank you very much. So I am going to call us to order. I am going to declare that we have a quorum because there are a goodly number of people of you here. And let us begin with prayer. Lord God, we give you thanks for the gift of this day, for this Sabbath day, when we have the privilege and freedom of coming and worshiping you in your sanctuary through technology, that we can be gathered as your people, spread among the world. Be with us as we do the work of this congregation, and we pray your blessing on all those who serve on the session of this church. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. The purpose of our meeting is, well, for one thing, we're here to elect a new elder to fill out our slate of names. Greg Dumars has agreed to serve, if elected, in the class of 2023. Are there any other nominations from the floor? Hearing none, I would entertain a motion that nominations be closed.
So moved.
Thank you. Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. We are ready now to vote on Greg Dumars serving in the class of 2023. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Motion carries. Greg, I want to thank you so very much for your willingness to step forward in leadership at this time. The church needs to have a full slate of names, people willing to serve Christ in a leadership position. So we pray wisdom on you in moving forward. And Greg has already been to the first session meeting. He couldn't vote, but he was there. So you're official now. I would entertain a motion that we adjourn. Thank you. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion?
Nope.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries.
Joy has come, for the Lord has come. Be open to the joy in your life. Be prepared to sing it in your heart and share it with others. We are called to be God's joyful people. So go out. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit.